Welcome to Neutral Side Action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. And the fans are on their feet awaiting the start of this game as the players line up for the kick. Fielded at the 4. Across the 30. He's tackled at the 32. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Decent run up the gut. Zips it to the tight end. And he's tackled at the 48. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
Here's a throw, and I don't think he got anything on that. Taken down at the 39-yard line. He keeps it and picks up maybe a yard. And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. Well, after that injury, we'll get to see the backup quarterback here. And he tackles him hard at the 36. Short gain there by the halfback for the first down.
Smart run. Maybe won't look great on the stat sheet, but getting the first is what matters.
Carries the ball for a nice gain.
That's good. Man, left, man, left. That'll bring up second and three.
Red two, yellow three. Yellow three.
He's on the run. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. Slides down to the ground.
This is the kind of steady, strong drive the coaches love to see. Right now, they're firing on all cylinders.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Nice run to the left there.
That makes it first and goal.
Touchdown, Auburn! What a spectacular run by the quarterback.
That is such a weapon for your offense when you have a quarterback who can do things like that. The coach probably loves drawing up plays for this guy.
And he converts the extra point. It was an 11-play, 68-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown. So our score, 7-0. Auburn lines up for the kickoff. The Tigers running back taken out earlier, sidelined with that injury. However, it looks like he's going to be able to come back in this game. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. The Bulldogs right now, Kirk, I think they've just got to play within themselves. Sometimes you get at home and you get just a little bit too fired up at the beginning of a game.
I agree with you. I think sometimes there's a tendency for certain teams to press a little bit because they're trying so hard to keep this home crowd in the game, and they've been waiting all week and they're so excited. Sometimes you force a play. Just let the play naturally come to you and react to it. So we'll see if this team playing at home jumps the gun a little bit, or if they just let the game come to them.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. He airs it out. And they make the stop at the 24-yard line.
This secondary better tighten it up. They're going to slow down this drive.
It's first down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air. Gets it out quickly. He's taken down at about the 11. They come out in a 5-wide set. He almost had it, but it's incomplete.
You never know what will happen when the ball ricochets like that. Good effort by the defender.
From the 11-yard line, second down. And he shoved out of bounds around the 8-yard line. It to the halfback, and he's got it again. They decided to go to the running back on that touchdown pass.
Just a nice job by the quarterback of showing great patience here, going through his progressions, finally finding the back to get into the end zone.
Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. And he tacks on the extra point. Georgia, the kick. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 28. So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
Finds his man and they take him down immediately. In trouble, and he hits him hard at the 26-yard line.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that this defense is putting on him.
Third and 11 here. Ball on the 26-yard line. Going long. Almost picked off.
Smart, heady play by that defender. That was solid, fundamental pass defense.
Gets to about the 47-yard line. The offense really came up with a nice drive there last time out, and most of those yards came through the air.
This defense needs to improve from front to back. The line needs to put more pressure on the quarterback, and the defensive backs need to stick it to these receivers with tighter coverage.
Slings it. So at the end of one, we get a tie game at 7-7. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. Nice run to the outside. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. As a man, he'll lose big yards. Nothing doing for the offense, and it's fourth down.
He was able to deaden that kick perfectly, and he gives them a long field to work with.
They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. They'll bring him down at the 21-yard line. A yard, maybe two on the carry. That makes it 7-8. Intercepted there. Here's third and eight. Ball on the 21-yard line. Quick strike and he drops it.
Strong showing by the defense. You always like to get the other team's offense off the field as fast as you can.
Great hit. He wasn't getting away from that one. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Quick throw to the tight end. Tackle made around the 40-yard line. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Fullback makes the catch for the first down, and they push him out at the 28-yard line.
Sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Has some daylight. And down he goes at the 17. From the 17-yard line, first down. Gets out to about the 15-yard line. They'll run it. The 10. He's pushed out of bounds at the 3.
What is going on with this defense? I mean, don't get me wrong. The offense is doing a nice job for first downs, and they're executing well. But the defense is just letting them maintain possession and move the ball right down the field. They've got to try to change things up with their scheme. Be more aggressive. Attack. Do some things to change it up. Take some risks.
Throws it. Watch out. Oh, almost had a pick. This is the 8th play of this drive. That brings him 6 and 1. Dives forward. The back gets 3 on the carry. That makes this 3rd and goal. From the 1-yard line. 3rd down. They've got their goal line sets on the field. This might be a good time for play action. Tries to get around the corner. Touchdown, Bulldogs. And he hits the PAT. So a 9-play, 49-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
Georgia is lining up to kick this one off from the 5-yard line. And he's tackled at the 33. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Scrambling around. Decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. He's at the 40. Slides down. At the 25-yard line. That's a gain of 11. First down. Little handoff. Brought down around the 25-yard line. The defense was all over that draw play.
And they got very good containment on the halfback. He had nowhere to go with the football.
From the 25-yard line, it's second down. Fires out to his wideout. He's tackled around the 20-yard line.
It really wasn't badly played by the defense, but sometimes a good throw and catch just beats you.
Quick throw, incomplete, one of his receiver.
They got lucky on that play. That receiver was wide open, but the quarterback just missed him.
So it's 4th down. So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. He gets it up, and the field goal is good. Auburn is ready to kick it away. From the 7. And he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. Georgia's offense is just clicking on all cylinders, Herbie, right now. It's everything they planned for, and it's all working.
Everything is coming together for this offense. They seem to be getting better with each series. And, you know, this game started where this team was, you know, they wondered if they were going to be able to move the ball against this defense. And I think right now, I think they seem to, as I said earlier, they seem to be growing with their confidence with each possession.
Quick shot to the open receiver, and he can't hang on to the ball. It's 2nd and 10. Ball on the 27-yard line. And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this 5-receiver look. Throws incomplete.
Number 18 was the intended receiver on the play. That brings us 3rd and 10.
Georgia holds a 4-point lead. Run right and hit the backfield. So they run the ball on 3rd and long, and it's stuck.
Well, Brad, here the offense is trying to surprise the defense with a run, but it didn't work.
Yeah. 8-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Pass incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver. From their own 38-yard line, it's second down. Throws and it's incomplete.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
They go to the screen here, and the halfback's got it. Knocked out of bounds at the 49-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
First and 10. Ball on the 49. He goes downtown. Can't connect. He looked like he just sort of aimed that one.
Yeah, he didn't look very natural throwing the football there, and the result was an underthrow.
Short pass, middle of the field. He's at the 40. And he's taken down at the 35-yard line.
Good job by the offensive line to pick up the linebacker on the blitz. That gave the quarterback enough time to find his man for a nice game.
So we'll probably get one last heave to the end zone here before halftime. Slings it left. And he's tackled
around the 11-yard line.
There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened. We've got a great game here, folks, as we reach the end of the first half. The Bulldogs lead it by 4.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. So far, so good for both offenses in terms of taking care of the football, but now the defenses are ramping up the sense of urgency in terms of trying to get the ball back for their offense.
Absolutely. You got to find Reese. These ball hawks on defense, they need to find the football. They need to make some big plays, create some turnovers. How about using that hit stick a little bit? How about knocking somebody silly and making them drop the football? I mean, defense's number one priority is trying to turn the football over, try to make a big explosive play for your offense so they can do more damage and they can take the ball down the field. So those ball hawks need to show themselves in the second half.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes 3 or 4 axe handles wide. Brandon Kirk will be there to call the second half.
Boy, I hope the second half's as good as the first. Just about set to start the third quarter in a tight one. Taken from the 3-yard line. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Georgia is up 4. He has some room. And they make the stop at the 43-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 43-yard line. Steps out at the 47-yard line. They'll work the left side. He's taken down around the 44-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 44. Right there. 30, makes it out to about the 26. Tigers wide receiver, we hope, can make a comeback, get back in this ball game. Went out with that injury a little bit earlier. Inside the 10. Touchdown, Georgia.
When you see that end zone in front of you, it can elevate your running to another level. Awesome play.
And he tacks on the extra point. A five-play, 75-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
And Brad, right now, the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big running lanes.
So the score now, 21-10. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He'll return it from the 6. Tackle at the 34-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Looking for the corner, and he is drilled at the 43. And they got him for a loss.
Ouch. Pretty big loss on the play, and I think they might want to reassess the strategy here. Perhaps run a screen, maybe hit the tight end on a short pattern. This D-line is just a bit much to handle at this moment.
Third down, 5 yards to go. Ball on the 38-yard line. Tack on the yardage. Nice gain, but not enough for the first down.
Yeah, that's a nice play there. They did everything right except get enough yards for the first down.
Everybody up close. It looks like they're coming after this kick. And he makes it out to about the 31-yard line.
It's early in this game, so the defense can still have an opportunity to make some adjustments. But if things don't turn around in a hurry, it's really going to start to affect the psyche of that defensive line.
He's to the 40. They'll bring him down at about the 39-yard line. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Gets hit out of bounds, right around the 40. That'll make it third and long. Tackle made around the 45-yard line. From the 45-yard line. First down. They keep it on the ground with a tailback. Nice run to the left there.
That'll bring up second and 3.
Gets out to around the 28. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 28-yard line. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. Fires quick to an open man. He dropped it.
Number 82 was the intention to see it one way. That makes it second and 10.
They'll knock him down for a loss.
Well, I think it's safe to say the defense had his number on that one. It can be very frustrating for a running back when he's stopped before he even gets going.
And this is the eighth play of the drive.
Showed superb athletic ability on that catch. You know, the ball isn't going to hit you in the numbers every time. As a receiver, you've got to be able to adjust quickly and sometimes be willing to give up your body.
From the 13-yard line, it's first down. And down he goes at the 4-yard line. Here's play number 10 on the drive.
Watch the screen, watch the screen. Watch the screen. Ready,
got his tight end touchdown.
So this entire group functions so well as a unit, and you saw it on that touchdown. Very good team effort.
He makes the PAT. Georgia to kick. He's to the 20. Georgia's continuing to play extremely tough defense. This has been impressive.
It's just been impressive to watch them play with such an attitude, almost a chip on their shoulder with the energy that they're playing with. I think it's going to require that kind of effort to be able to win this game.
The last time this offense had the ball, it was 3 and out.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
He gets to about the 41-yard line. And they were lucky that one didn't go for more.
They looked like they've never defended the option before. The tailback had a ton of running room there.
Gains his way to the 49-yard line.
That makes it 6-2.
Good discipline here by the defense, stringing the option out and plugging the running lanes. That moved them back.
That's 3 down and 1 to go. Georgia's up by 18. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number 4. He's at the 40. Gains his way to the 39-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Hey, kill.
Halfback's got it on the quick throw. Tackle at the 30-yard line.
Makes the reception. That's a gain of 9 on the play. That brings up second and 9.
The toughness here by this quarterback of sitting in until the last second, trying to make a play downfield, only to have this defense get to him. He's got to do a better job maybe feeling things out a little bit, but at least he has the awareness and a toughness to sit in that pocket.
Throws middle to the tight end, and he's level at the 18. Carries the ball for a nice gain.
Call it a gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and 4.
Pitch out. Got the corner. Nice gain as he works the right side.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. That makes it first and goal.
10th play of the drive. Backup quarterback into the game now to call the signals. Pitches back. Touchdown, Auburn! And they're looking to get 2 points here. A nice 10-play, 76-yard drive. But the failed 2-point conversion keeps it a 6-point score. And down he goes at the 42-yard line. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. They'll work the left. Gains his way to the 30-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 30-yard line. He's hit and taken down.
That makes it second and 2.
Just under 3 to go in regulation. Inside the 10. He's tackled
around the 4-yard line.
Very well designed play that time to give him a first down. The linemen executed their blocks nicely and it went for a good game.
And goal from the 3. They're knocking on the door. They've got their goal line sets on the field. This might be a good time for play action. Throw caught, touchdown. How about the tight end? This guy can play some football.
You bet he can. He's such an all-around player. He's just as good at blocking as he is at catching the football.
Splits the uprights with the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He'll return it from the 1. And he's tackled at the 17-yard line.
This is my kind of game. We're getting a chance to see so many touchdowns. I just wonder if this offense could continue the flow that we've seen from the previous 3 series.
Sure, that touchdown and their last possession's given them some confidence, but let's see if that carries them back down the field. Just under 2 minutes in the game. And he throws it away.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, 5 wide receivers in the formation. Makes the catch and look out. Knocked out of bounds at the 32. First from their own 32-yard line. First down. The defense has got some of their best pass defenders on the field. They set up in the dime to counter that five wide receiver set. Quick throw out to the receiver. Brought down around the 46-yard line. Caught, open field, and he's tackled at the 46-yard line. He chucks it downfield.
Great play for the offense, a great call by the offense, but the defense has to change things up. They've got to put more pressure on this quarterback.
And they've got all their DBs in there to match up against the five-wide set. Caught out in the open. And he tackles him hard at the 8. Auburn just took their first time out. From the 8-yard line. Second down. Under a minute left. Tackle after a decent run up the gut.
The thing I love about this guy is he can throw the ball, he can run it. Man, that's hard to stop.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Zipped it out, and that was almost picked off.
How did he drop that? The defender did everything that he needs to do. He read the play perfectly. He stepped up, and what does he do? Drops the interception. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
Diving for extra yardage. Just throws this one away. So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Stop defensively.
Yeah, they only needed a few yards here to keep the drive alive. Great job by the defense to shut them down.
You really can't say enough about this defense. Fourth and short, and they really showed up on that play. And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
Gains his way to the 10-yard line. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. That's going to do it for this one. Our final score, Georgia 35, Auburn 16. Let's get Kirk Herbstreit's final thoughts on this one. Herbie, what do you got for us?
Georgia came out here today and played with the heart and intensity that you love to see in a rivalry game. They should be very proud of their victory because wins don't come easy between these two teams.
That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.